गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टडी अबाउट द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ यूनिट 1, दैट इज मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ लीव्स। द मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ लीव्स इज ऑफ द फॉलोइंग टाइप्स: लीफ टेंड्रिल्स, स्पाइन्स, फाइलोड, लीफ मॉडिफिकेशन फॉर स्टोरेज, लीफ modification for trapping the insects, leaf modification for reproduction, floral leaves and scale leaves. Then first one, that is leaf modification as tendrils. In many weak stem plants, the leaves are modified into slender, wiry and coiled structures called leaf tendrils. The tendrils may be formed by entire leaf or a part of the leaf. In wild pea plant, that is Lithrus apaca, the entire leaf get modified into tendrils. While in Pisum sativum, that is pea plant and sweet pea, terminal leaflets modified into tendrils. In some other cases, leaf tip get modified into tendrils. Example is Gloriosa. In some, petiole is modified into tendril. Example, Clematis. In others, stipules get modified into tendril. Smilax. And in insectivorous plant, that is Nepenthes, midrib get modified into tendril. Midrib of the leaf get modified into tendrils. Example, Nepenthes. It is a insectivorous plant. Second one, modification of leaf, that is spines. The pointed structure formed by the modification of entire leaf or part of leaf is called spine. Different parts of leaf or entire leaf may be modified into spine. In Opuntia, leaves of axillary branches are modified into spine. In Barberries, entire leaf get modified into three spines. In Citrus, first leaf of axillary branch get modified into spine. In Argemon, leaf margin modified into spines. In Parkinsonia, Acacia and Ziziphus, stipules get modified into spines. Next one, that is Phyllode. It is a green expanded structure formed by the modification of petiole or rachis of leaf. Many xerophytes reduce the size of their leaves to minimize water loss. Such plants develop phyllodes to carry out photosynthesis. Example, Acacia, Parkinsonia, Melanogyla. Then storage leaves. Leaves become fleshy due to storage of water or food material. Such leaves are called storage leaves. They are usually found in succulent plants. In plants like aloe, Peperomia, the storage type of leaves are present. Then trap leaves. The trap leaves are also called insectivorous leaves or carnivorous leaves. plants having trap leaves usually grow in nitrogen deficient soils. They have poorly developed root system. These plants get their nitrogenous requirement by capturing the insects. To attract, capture, kill and digest the insect, the leaves are modified into trap leaves. Then reproductive leaves. In some plants, the vegetative propagation is carried out by the production of epiphyllous buds on leaves. In bryophyllum, the leaf margin is having number of notches, and in notch there are present buds. Means when they come in contact with soil, in notch region it forms bud, and from below side it forms the roots. In this manner, new plant vegetative propagation takes place. Such leaves are called reproductive leaves. The epiphyllous buds, when come in contact with soil, develop into new plant. Then floral leaves. Floral parts such as sepal, petals, stamen and carpels are modified leaves. Sepals and petals are leafy, while stamens are considered pollen-bearing microsporophylls and carpels are ovule-bearing megasporophylls. Last one, that is scale leaves. In many xerophytes, the foliage leaves are reduced to scale leaves. They are thin, membranous, dry, small, sessile. Sessile means without petiole, colorless structures. They are found in Orobanche and Balanophora. This is all about the modification of leaves. Now we completed the unique one of paper one. Thank you.